Design Thinking and Agile Development at IBM Workload Scheduler. In a world that is rapidly changing in all its aspects, how can we consume goods and services is fundamentally changing, which also means that companies must evolve in how they design and build their products. In this context, we, as the IBM Workload Scheduler team, have left waterfall methodology and for the past decade have been applying design thinking and agile development, achieving a continuous improvement in customer satisfaction ratings. A key success factor is IBM Design Thinking, a framework for delivering a great user experience to customers. It is based on three principles: a focus on user outcomes, multidisciplinary teams, and a spirit of continuous reinvention. Traditional design thinking methods are understand, explore, prototype, and evaluate. IBM has expanded upon traditional design thinking by adding three key practices: hills, sponsor users, and playbacks. This is called IBM Design Thinking. Let's see how IBM Design Thinking and Agile Development work with IBM Workload Scheduler. We start by thoroughly understanding who our users are. What do they think? How do they feel? What do they see, hear, say, and do? The user as is experience scenarios, the pain points that users experience, and the opportunities that enhance the user experience. We define personas to develop empathy with users. Here's an example of an empathy map for the as-is scenario, which we used during a project for a cognitive scheduling troubleshooting console. It's important to find users or potential users willing to establish an ongoing relationship, provide insights that otherwise would get missed, and evaluate and validate our solution. These are the sponsor users. They help shape our solutions. They bring their lived experience and expertise to our team. Sponsor users can also be business partners or sales team representatives. For each release of the product, designers and developers collaborate with product management to identify the hills that can be set as the guide for the project. A hill is a state of intent. Hills turn user needs into project goals, helping our team align around a common understanding of the intended outcomes. And every hill has a wow factor, a measurable outcome of the user experience. Let's see an example of the hills at IBM Workload Scheduler. We then explore many widely divergent and creative to-be opportunities and their effects on the user experience. We then prototype the designs, often initially using paper prototypes for speed. Prototypes transform concepts into artifacts. We then evaluate the prototypes with users, and based on their feedback, we iterate on the designs if needed. Let's see an example of the Dynamic Workload Console paper prototype. With playbacks, we align our team, stakeholders, and users around scenarios that show the value of our offering. We conduct frequent playbacks of our scenarios, from low-fidelity prototypes to more stable high-fidelity prototypes, and finally, to working code. By involving our users from day one on a project, we improve the user experience, but also increase our speed and delivery. The space where we work is also important. In the Rome Software Laboratory, we have a creative design space where we can collaborate to apply IBM Design Thinking methodology and create new user-centered solutions. In addition to IBM Design Thinking, we apply Agile methodology to our development cycle. Agile's core concepts are iterative development, risk management, and transparency. By applying Agile development, we can release user-ready products every month instead of every year. We always start with the outcome in mind, working in small autonomous squad teams, adapting work to changing business objectives. the beginning of each iteration, also called sprint, each squad team holds a storyboarding session to plan the tasks they will complete. During this meeting, the team clarifies all the requirements. Each player gives their opinion based on the complexity of the story and their knowledge of the code to be changed. Continuous delivery can reduce time to release from several months to just a few hours. Without the right testing, the continuous delivery process might fail. Continuous testing isn't just a process, it's a team-wide culture. Replacing manual testing with automated testing allows our processes to run faster and more smoothly. In the most recent workload scheduler development cycle, more than 70% of the new features were tested with an automation suite. For each iteration, we, as the information developers, are tasked with documenting new features, including a number of videos that demonstrate the business value of the new feature. Stakeholders help us define the storyline and content of each video. Stand-up meetings are a great technique to get everyone in the team up to speed, to facilitate brainstorming sessions, and to enable collaboration. Through daily stand-up meetings, we can adjust our course and correct any issues or impediments that might prevent us from accomplishing the goals we have outlined for ourselves. At the end of each iteration, each squad team takes time to reflect about what happened. We all sit together and discuss what we did well and what we didn't do so well, and what actions should be taken for the next iteration. We encourage self-direction to unleash innovation instead of concentrating the decision-making into the hands of a select few. We don't need project management. We are a self-managed team. We always deliver projects fast, and our stakeholders can see our progress at every iteration on IBM Marketplace What's New page or on Demo Day. Every 3 to 4 weeks, a demo session is set up with the team, stakeholders, and customers to present what we have accomplished. Finally, we want to add value to our customer relationships, transferring the Agile principles to our customers to help them increase revenue, lower costs, and translate into a culture of constant improvement. Are the latest updates regarding our releases. IBM Workload Scheduler version 9.3 was released in April 2015. Fix Pack 1 was released in December 2015, delivering more cognitive capabilities. Fix Pack 2 was released in May 2016, providing new solutions for hybrid environments. Hybrid workload automation spans on-premises, on-cloud, software as a service, and IBM Bluemix offerings. Software as a service and Bluemix offerings are updated every month with new functionalities. More than 50 customer requests for enhancements were satisfied in IBM Workload Scheduler Fix Pack 1 and 2. Adopt the latest release. Become a sponsor user. Be part of a journey to excellence. And follow our progress on IBM Marketplace. Thanks for watching.